crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Selbel. In this video, I would like to start participating in the Helium project over at helium.com. It's the people-powered network for the Internet of Things. What I've got to do is I have to set up a Helium hotspot. So 10 days ago, I went to the Panther X website. The URL is a bit complicated and I've got an affiliate link, which makes it even more complicated. It's panther-web.myshopify.com/VIP. So if you like to support me a little bit, then use this affiliate link. And over there, we have the Panther X hotspot on sale. And they say it's shipping within 3 days from China. So what I did, I chose the EU model because I am in Germany and added it to the cart. I went to checkout and there I applied a discount code VIP rate, and that gave me another $25 off. I went through the checkout, and one thing that is probably a little bit unusual for some people is that they require me to pay in cryptocurrency. They gave me a number of options and I chose Binance US dollar, which brought me to a transaction page, which basically said, please send 473.18 Binance US dollars to the following address. So I went to Binance.com. If I would be in the USA, I would go to Binance.us, and I still had some Binance US dollars. Otherwise, I would just top up my fiat currency on Binance. For that, I would go to buy crypto, then bank deposit. And I would choose the bank transfer. I would make a SEPA transfer because that costs only 1 euro transaction fee, while using my credit card would cost me 1.8%. Over here, it says it's 1 to 2 business days. On the other hand, if I make it an instant deposit on a weekday, it will just take 1 hour or something. So I would choose that. I would say, okay, I want to deposit, let's say 450 euro, and then continue, and then just go through the process. Once that money arrived, then I would go to buy crypto from cash balance. And I would enter 450 euro and I would choose Binance US dollars, BUSD over here, which gives me 481 BUSD, which is enough to pay for the Panther X2 gateway. So I click continue, confirm. Click refresh. Yeah, purchase is complete. Now I would withdraw this BUSD to the payment gateway. I would go to my wallet. I scroll down to BUSD. I click withdraw. I select a new address, and now I copy the wallet address of the payment gateway and paste it into the Binance address field. Now it's super important that I choose BSC for Binance Smart Chain as my network. And yes, I'm sure about that. And now I copy the exact amount, the 473.18 BUSD, into the amount field. And if I now click withdraw, then this money goes to the payment gateway. In my case, the order is already complete, so I don't send them the money again. I just wanted to quickly show you the process. And after that, it took 10 days until FedEx delivered the gateway this morning. It comes in a nice box. There is a nice instruction manual, the gateway, Then there is a 3 dB antenna, a power adapter, and a pin, which I need for the activation of Bluetooth. I attach the antenna before I power it on, and only then I plug in the power adapter. After inserting the power adapter, the power LED is on and the status LED is blinking. I think that's a good moment to give the gateway a little bit of time to boot up. And in the meantime, I care about the Helium app on my phone. I already installed the Helium app on my Android, but I didn't set it up yet. It turns out that the Helium app does not let me film my Android screen with the screen capture software, but no problem. I will just take some photographs of the screen and walk you through the process. I created my account and now it asks me to add a Helium miner. I use the pin to press the Bluetooth button at the back of the gateway and now it should be discoverable. Now I say add a miner, and in the first attempt it scanned but did not find my hotspot. So I disabled Bluetooth on my phone and enabled it again and scanned a second time. And now it says I found the Panther X2 hotspot. The app connects to the hotspot. It shows me my Wi-Fi network so that I can connect the Panther X2 to my local Wi-Fi network. It asks me a couple of questions regarding the exact location and the antenna and stuff like that. And finally, it says registering the hotspot. This can take a few minutes. So I think I am done with the app. The next thing I would like to do is enabling port forwarding in my internet router. Maybe in my case, it would not even be necessary to open the port. But then again, maybe sooner or later, I would run into trouble. I have a DSL router called Fritzbox, which is popular in Germany. Maybe your router is completely different. I have to go to internet and then the forwardings. I would say I add a new device for forwarding. I try to find my Panther X2 device. It's over there. Some people who have problems with Helium, they need to use the exposed host feature for their router, but that sounds a little bit like overkill. So I will first try to say, I want to add a port forwarding. I say it's some application, let's say Helium, it doesn't matter. The protocol is TCP. And the port is 44158. And for IPv4, we need to repeat that over here. I click OK. That should be it for the port. And my last step is to relocate the router to our attic. I want it at the highest point of this building, so that it has got the best reception. In the attic, I hung up a little shelf for gateways like the Panther X2. This way I can place them directly underneath the roof. And I'm aware that the current antenna is not ideal. So my next project will be to replace the 3 dB antenna that came with the gateway with an 8 dB fiberglass antenna. I'm living in a rural area. Everything is flat around here, but the next city is a little bit away. So I believe an 8 dB antenna is much more suitable for my situation than this 3 dB antenna. But that's something I will do after I see that the gateway started working. Let me know if I did anything stupid in this video. I could do anything better. It's the very first time that I set up a Helium gateway. I hope this video is useful for you. Let me know in the comments what you think. And then I hope I see you in the next video.